Wolfpack News for October 3, 2014. Topping the news, Ebola cases are beginning to rise. It has been said that Ebola cases in Liberia and Sierra Leone could reach up to 550,000 by January, as the Center of Disease and Control Prevention has predicted. The official death toll has climbed up to 2,800 in 6 months, along with 5,800 confirmed cases in West Africa. Although, according to CDC, they have estimated that if 70% of Ebola cases are cured properly, that the epidemic will decrease and eventually end. In other news, a former state prison clerk is blamed for her own rape by the Pennsylvania Attorney General's office. The former clerk was choked, unconscious, and raped for 27 minutes by inmate Omar Best. He was previously convicted for multiple other sex-related crimes. He was previously transferred to another state prison for assaulting a female assistant there. He is now serving a life sentence for the woman's rape. Meanwhile, students from Denver area schools walked out of their classrooms in order to protest a proposal made by a member of the Jefferson County School Board. Students, along with their parents, are accusing the school board of censoring U.S. history. When at least 50 teachers called in sick, protests took place on Friday, while student walkouts occurred on Monday. The goal is to give all of the community more of a say in what is taught in the classrooms, as said by Ken Witt, the school board president. For news closer to home, the fall play is coming up. This year, the fall play is a French comedy. The cast and crew are working together in order to prepare for the upcoming shows. There is a lot that goes into making and putting on a show from both the crew and cast. They both have been putting hard work and dedication, have been meeting since September, and have had rehearsals every day.
School body should come see the show because you'll see a lot of familiar faces, which is always fun, seeing your friends on stage. And also, it's just funny. It's a fun way to spend your evening. The show this year is not that long, so on a school night, Thursday, or for the weekend, it's just a fun way to spend an hour and a half. And just as you go to the football games on Friday nights supporting student athletes, you should support the arts and support your student actors.
The fall play will have four performances, October 23rd at 6 p.m., October 24th at 7 p.m., and two performances on October 25th, one at 2 p.m. and one at 7 p.m. Be sure to come and support the drama department. In entertainment news, the lawsuit for the crash that resulted in the death of actor Paul Walker with Porsche still continues. Lawyers on the case say it is ongoing but suffering severe setbacks in court. The only allegation that will not be dismissed on the case is the strict liability claim. This allegation will remain due to the lack of a racing fuel cell along with a crash cage on the car. That's today's edition of Wolfpack News. I'm Samantha Hornbaker. Join us again tomorrow and have a wonderful day.